Hello, 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 welcome and everybody. So on the live of today, this live is for painters, is for drawers, and we're going to talk about colors, and I'm going to show you a little bit how you can mix your colors. So if you're a painter, if you're a drawer, and you like to learn a little bit more how you can mix your colors to obtain the exact color that you like, this is what we're going to see today during this online workshop. So this is going to last for about 15 or 20 minutes. And so first of all, I wanted to show you, here is my blog, anneliesadriaansen.com/blog, because there I have created this wonderful gift for you. I have written an ebook, which you can download on my blog. This is here my blog. And anneliesadriaansen.com/blog, and there you can go to download your free ebook. I have written that ebook. There are so many good things that you can learn there if you are a painter and you're starting to paint and you would like to learn a little more about some techniques. I show you some easy some techniques if you would like to improve your drawing style. I explain also that you can discover there the 3 secrets for making the colors of your art look amazing. And I learn you also how important value contrast is to make powerful paintings. Also, I'm speaking about texture when you're painting and how you can paint trees, for example, trees, how you can obtain that one single color. Also, if you're in search for inspiration, I'm gonna give you a lot of information like this that can be really helpful for you if you would like to improve your painting style. So let's go for another live. I'm here every 2 weeks, and every time, sometimes I'm gonna have interviewing another artist, another painter, and we're gonna talk a little bit about art making, creativity, and sometimes I'm gonna do an online workshop, as we're gonna do today. And today we're gonna talk about colors, and we're gonna talk about indigo blue more recently, because in the beginning of the week I have posted that question on the Facebook, on my Facebook page. And the question was, if you can choose only one color to paint, which one would it be? And I had so many great response of so many people. It was just great to see this, how the people reacted on that question. And I will answer on that question. So for me, it is indigo blue. And I'm going to show you here a little bit how I proceed when I am in search to find just that one color for my painting. Often I like to paint from pictures, and this is what we are going to do a little bit here. So I have taken here this image of this blue scarf, where you can find just that wonderful indigo blue. I was traveling to Morocco several years ago, and I bought there those typical blue scarves. And that blue is just, I think, is just amazing, because it's really the blue that you can find when you look at the Mediterranean Sea. This is a blue that you can find in the middle of the summer, and you take a look in the sky, and you have that deep blue like this. It's just a little bit green, but also very, very, very deep blue, and that indigo blue that's one of my favorite colors, as you can see. So I'm going to show you here a little bit how I proceed when I'm in search for a color, when I'm preparing myself to paint, and I'm experimenting a little bit like this on my color palette to find just that one color. So when I start to prepare my panel, even if I'm going to paint only blue, always I will put 3 primary colors on my palette. Primary red, primary yellow, and primary blue. As you can see here, it's a little bit dirty. I use it a lot. And I even have 2 different blues. I use primary blue and ultramarine blue. And also I have always titanium white on my palette. And with these colors, I can create already so many different colors. So this is just what I like to do when I paint. It's a little bit of experimenting, playing around. So let's go. I'm gonna put on my palette here just a little bit of primary yellow. I'm gonna show you just after how I proceed. A little bit of that yellow, a little bit of that wonderful red here. I'm going to show you just after. I'm going to put a little bit of that blue here, that primary blue. I love it so much, that color. And a little bit of that second blue. So remember, most of the time I put two different yellows, two different reds, two different blues, and my white, of course. And with that, I can do so many things. This is what I love. When I'm mixing colors, it's just playing around, experimenting around. You can see here. Ta-da! So let's go. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to try to mix a little bit these colors, and I'm going to try to reach as close as possible this color. This is what I'm searching for, okay? So I'm going to mix my colors here, and I'm going to put a little bit on the paper here, the paint, and if I see that I'm just getting close to that one color that I love, this is what I'm going to try out. So if you put your blue, which comes straight out of the tube, this is ultramarine blue. I never use pure colors straight out of the tube because I think they're not very personal. I think it's very important to always mix your colors. This is I'm just going to hide this. So you're going to, okay, now you're going to see it a little bit better. Okay, let's check it out. So this is ultramarine blue. And here, this is primary blue. This is just a wonderful color also. You see, this is the one that I will need. You see, it's getting close already, this one. So I'm gonna take a little bit of that primary blue here. I'm gonna take a little bit of that primary blue, and I'm gonna add a little bit of that ultramarine blue in it. Just a little bit of white. All right, we have already, so this is already a color that I like. Little more of that white. A little bit more of that white. I hope that you can see this because these are already wonderful colors. It's already what I like. We are already very good here. You see this? How quickly? But it's a little bit too cold. I always put a little bit of every of the three primary colors in my color mixing. So I'm going to a little bit more of the two blues. And now I'm going to add just a little bit red also. Not too much because I'm not in search to find violet. But it's going to be just a little bit warmer. Yes, this is what I like. This is better. Just a little bit of red. You see, these nuances are so subtle. Now we are closer here already, but I need to mix a little bit more white in it. Just a little bit more white. You see, yes, this is the one. Maybe just a little bit more red. I didn't use any yellow for the moment. A little bit more red. A little bit more white. See how different these two blues are? I already have my color, and I'm just going to try a little bit. Of course, if I'm going to put yellow in it, it's going to be green. That's not at all. Well, this is going to be a little better here for the parts where it's darker here. Oh yes, this is gonna work as well. This is a wonderful color as well. Okay. You really should try this out at home, because when I am mixing my colors, the importance is really to experiment and to play with your colors. It is when you're experimenting and playing around a little bit that you will see and you will discover how many possibilities you will have when you are mixing your colors, when you are trying new things out. Okay, so just let's do a color here in way much more red. This is not at all what we are looking for. Do you see the difference here? This is way too blue. This is way too violet. Okay, so you see how quickly, with just a few colors, you can find that one color, and I often do this. So just putting a little bit of your color that you have mixed on your image or just beside it like this, and then you see the nuances. This was too blue, too dark, these are too saturated, this one was a very good one. This one was even better. I put a little bit more red and a little bit more blue, and that's the one that I need. Okay, so this is a very good exercise if you're looking just for that one particular color before you start to paint. So during this live, of course, you can ask me some questions. So if you have any questions about the few things that I explained here, please don't hesitate. You can ask them here in the comments below. I will be glad to answer them. And otherwise, you can answer them also tomorrow in the replay of this video. I will answer them. I will be very happy to help you on your way. And before we will end this workshop, again, I invite you to go to my blog and download your free ebook. I'm giving you so much information and details. If you are a painter or you like to start to paint, I'm gonna put it just like this here again. Oh, I'm sorry. Like this. This is my blog, and just below you have the button to download your ebook. Those are 16 pages where I give so much precious information, and I'm sure it will help you on the way to start to paint. So I am so happy that you were here today and that you were here for listening to me. And I'm wishing you a very pleasant end of the day. And I hope you will be here again next time. And see you soon for our next live. Bye-bye.